Act protection, how not to implement the license protection in .NET system. She told us.
Hi. So current talk is about implementation and how to not to implement the protection of intellectual property in .NET systems. So we'll talk about some approaches. And let's see. So who am I? I'm a security research manager at Spider Labs in TrustWeb. So it's a great place, recommended. Before, I worked in Checkmarks as a security lead and software architect. And before, many years ago, worked in Elbit, the Janitor system. Today's topic is not related to WAF and web server security, it's something different. It's all about .NET. And, more specific, it's about intellectual property. As some of you know, IP.NET is a funny acronym that can be easily translated into IP now by Google Translate, if you translate, for example, in this way. Actually, all .NET can be easily translated to .no in sense of application security and keeping your secrets. So purpose of current talk is actually is an impossible mission. It's how to protect the valuable information in .NET code. .NET platform is a very good choice for algorithms, for prototyping, for rapid development, and for many other cases, but not so suitable for storing your secrets. And I want to show how system itself makes the attacker life much easier. So what is valuable information and what and why it's impossible to protect. So I put here some secrets that can be found in code sorted by potential damage to your business. So source code and algorithms, it's painful if it leaked, but it's not catastrophic in most cases. Worse if system restrictions, limitations, hidden abilities are leaked. More worse when URLs and database connection strings available to attacker. And of course, passwords, keys for symmetric or asymmetric encryption, any sort of hard-coded strings that can lead to certificates or private IDs or keys, it can be placed in your code only for hacker's pleasure. Also, license enforcement, restrictions, limitations is also the very important secret that good to be remain a secret. And why it's impossible? Mostly because of architecture and philosophy of .NET. Everything .NET is open to investigation and to easy investigation. And even the worst reason, it's easy investigation by free automatic tools that can be downloaded from GitHub. On deployed system that already compiled and deployed, you can see the code, metadata, system calls, call tables, memory, heap, strings, and everything. And you can do this with simple tools. By looking to the structure of data, and to the heap, you can see real values of class instances and variables, and see strings in clear text. Also, you can inject code into compiled binaries and change behavior of the system on the fly or almost on the fly. So why we can go to fight anyway? Because we can make the attacker work harder. Let's see a short example. second. So continue later, we'll show some examples. So why we can talk about impossible protection and where we can start and when we can stop. System protection and hacking is a set of economic questions. So the just effort or revenue equation. So there are a few questions here. Is hacking your system will give economic effort or economic value to attacker? What's the revenue? And is the revenue is good enough to attacker to for asked effort? And how much resources attacker must invest to hack in your system? And how easy to reproduce a breach when it's published? Also, how long it will take to you to know that system was compromised and understand the real amount of damage? How fast you can respond and fix the holes? And when you can answer all these questions, you can go with your .NET system to the jungle or to the market. So how we can protect the property in this jungle? Here I want to show some basic approaches. Basic approach is very simple. Let's use obfuscation. Obfuscation is a standard tool. There are many different almost free tools that can do the obfuscation. It's easy, standard, and can be applied without code changes. But wrong. The interface are not obfuscated by most tools. Even by sophisticated tools, when you do obfuscation only on part of your code. So many of interface remains open and can be easily found and updated by hacker. At least you need to change your interface before obfuscation. And deobfuscation tools can be downloaded from GitHub and easiest to use and tools for obfuscation. I will try again to show some samples. This is screen, it's, I have some issue with this. So for example, a very simple tool that most of you already know, I'm sure, it's IlSpy that I put here my compiled binary. It's compiled in the release mode. And by investigation this exe, you just can't see all code in clear text. Even secret algorithms. Test of license, for example, some button, they check the license. Let's see what this sophisticated system can do. It's just test for license. Let's test what we will see in obfuscated code. So I do some basic obfuscation. Try to open this same tool again. Let's see what's the difference and if obfuscation really helped me. As you can see, almost remains the same. I continue to see my code. It's a little bit obfuscated, but not too much, so it's not stopping to understand what happens. You just see the code. And you can update it. You'll see in later how we can update obfuscated code and change behavior of the system. The problem with obfuscation is that not all obfuscator can do correct string encryption, and in most cases, every string, include the URLs, keys, and connection string remains open to hacker, or sometimes it's almost open and can be easily decrypted by analyzing the obfuscated code. Algorithms can be easily transferred to pseudocode and analyzed also. As we can see here, in back to the example, how we can analyze the code of how we can analyze encrypted code and understand exactly what the algorithms do. So it's only change that we see in encryption in obfuscation is name of the variables and sometimes the names of internal interfaces. But it's not too problem for us to understand what happened. For example, I will try to update the system. So invoke a standard disassembler from my Microsoft. It's located in a Microsoft SDK. It's produce assembly code. I just will search for license string. And we'll try to update it without deobfuscation. This is look like some license test. So we can see in assembly, for example, license is okay or license is wrong. So we can just put here. You see it's address of flow with a license okay. Save and recompile. What is the file name? So complete successfully. It's produce application. Sorry, I need to put delays here. Because the line delay is not affected by this crack, but I need to put it in the same folder to run. Wow, nice, we have a license. So we put some assembly change in obfuscated code. And without affecting the sophisticated license DLL. It's only affected only call to this DLL. When we use tools, for example, D4DOT, it's a well-known tools for decompilation. We can return back almost any kind of obfuscation. I just show. There is a one second. It's can see from so I'm trying to deobfuscate the obfuscated version of my binary. Now it's deobfuscated. Put in some place with folder. Let's see. Yeah. Investigation cleaned. So we'll return to ill. Spy, let's see, that's all our code is returns. So magic not work with it, spy. But as you see, you can work without without this. So it's some problem with the tool, probably. Let's continue. Have something in addition to say. So as I say, everything is possible to change even after obfuscation. At least simple obfuscation is not issue for attacker. And what is the solution? Maybe we will do double obfuscation. Obfuscate twice with same tool, but it will not work. We just can use a defuscator twice. So if you want to use obfuscation, use different tools in line, and I will show how. And there is an ultimate weapon against all kinds of obfuscation. When attacker can build his own library with your interfaces and own code in interesting functions that contains test for license or for certificates or for keys. Other functions can be bypassed to original binary. It's kind of a delay in the middle solution. It will not be shown here due to some problems with the presentation, but it can be an ultimate killer of obfuscation. And what about internal DLL with C code that we cannot easy to deassemble C code DLLs? So the problem that you must call this DLL from somewhere in .NET code, and these places can be attacked. And in addition, it will not prevent the memory mapping and heap investigations on these places. This option but can help a little bit with hiding the algorithm and some of business logics. Will not help so much with license enforcement. Some of basic approach I put here in one slide. It's some kind of dialogue of a developer with a hacker. So important DLL is seen. Is it enough? So attacker can ask if you test who is a signer of the DLLs. Okay, we're adding test for signer also. Is signer ID hard-coded? Can be nice. Can retrieve the private key, or just can affect your code and insert our key. So you will test for my signature and not for your signature. Okay, we will implement encryption, obfuscation of all these functions. But that attacker can replace whole function, then test for license with his own function. In a simple place, in simple way that, as we see, by editing even in a notepad. So we can encrypt everything is obfuscated and synced with certificates. So it will be some pain to maintain the system with total encryptions, but it can be a solution. But attacker can search for use of a crypto API in your DLLs and figure out what DLL can be attacked or what DLL must be attacked, because we will not use crypto DLL in every place. It probably will be only on interesting places to attack it. So what we can do? Actually, we can start with not to do. We will not store anything hard-coded. No password, no keys, no connection strings in code. Everything that you have in code can be analyzed, or sometimes it can be replaced by hacker. And when a system will be compromised, it will be hard to change the code again and to push the updates to all customers. It depends on your system, of course. And don't do single point of security check. Maybe it's one of the single cases when a copy paste in your code is allowed. Just do many point of security checks. Additional don't do's is remember when you build your secrets dynamically and store in simple form in the memory, it also can be stolen and can be investigated. So do something more complicated and use crypto libraries to store the secret. For example, crypto string instead of strings and so on. In .NET world, all memory is accessible with easy by simple tools. When you smash the secret between your code and date, so we do some pseudo-static calculation to store the key, it's only illusion of defense. It does not change anything. Your secret key is still available in the memory. Or when an attacker will gain access to your code after defuscation, and can just run the same code and get access to your hidden key. So don't do smash of secret in code. Anything hard for it. So what we can do? So add extra calls for encryption API into license testing in every place in your code, even when this is not needed to complicate the automatic search. This will add extra work to attacker. Add random keys and suspicious strings into your code, but not your string, but not your important information. Nice. So use randomization keys that just place it in your code, the attacker will spend time to analyze it. And to multiply the security checks. In this case, as a former software architect, I can send say you, this is a place when you can do copy-paste and multiply your test. And important, try to break into your system by yourselves. Do it before the hacker do. So use strong encryptions. Don't produce encryption for yourself. It's a lot of good tools in the market. So do strong encryption and strong randomization. And implement and use the revocation mechanism for keys and for certificates. Be responsive to breaches. And use more sophisticated, more complicated protocols than use of functions. With the protocols with name is license okay. It can be hacked too easy. As you've shown, even on a obfuscated code, it can be found easily. So use something more complicated to ensure the license policy. And add a strong digital signature to all DLLs in your system. To all binaries and every time check it, not only on startup time, check it periodically, even when you don't need it exactly. This will prevent or add additional effort to attacker to replace the DLLs or to analyze it. And check the signature and signer's ID every time, but not by storing them in the code. And be able to update the security mechanism without code updates and without reinstallation of the system at customer side, because it's not possible in most cases. It will allow you to be responsive to possible breach quickly. And yes, you can use different obfuscation tools at once, one after other, but using in most evil mode each of them. You can use, for example, .fuscator with most evil mode, and after .fuscator, use .reactor, for example, is his most able mode. Everyone with his own string encryption and call flow obfuscation. This it will not give you unbreakable system, but analyzing and breaking into this system will be much, much harder. So maybe it will be not economical. For example, I'll try to show what the reactor can do after when it works on obfuscated DLLs. It's again to the pain of this screen. So the additional obfuscation tool remember? As you see, this code is we cannot analyze with IL-SPY. At least we need more sophisticated tools to understand what happens here. It's not impossible to understand, because some interfaces remain open, and sometimes it also can be analyzed. But again, not with this tool, it's more sophisticated. But when you use inline, for example, .fuscator with most encryption, and after this you will use a reactor with most encryption, it will make attacker work much harder. So maybe it will turn the breach into non-economical. It will take too many resources to breach, and when you will be able to update the systems quickly, he will need to breach again in some places. So almost finished the talk, and thank you for patience and for quit snoring. Here is my contacts. Now I work in security research, not so close to .NET, working on WAF, web application firewall, and web server security. You see my contacts, happy to meet you after the meeting. Thank you.